Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create simple 3D text with deep shadows using Photoshop's 3D filter. The 3D filter we'll be using in this tutorial is in version CS6 Extended and later. The 3D filter in CS5 Extended uses a different interface. If your 3D filter is grayed out or not working properly, it could be due to a number of reasons that I listed in my video's description. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl N on Windows or Command N on a Mac. Make the width and the height 3000 pixels each and the resolution 150 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the box and in the brightness field, type in 40%. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm using Pricedown Black. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make it size 96 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click the box to open the color picker. In the brightness field, type in 80% and click OK. Click on your document and type out your text. It should be approximately this size. To center it, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. At the top, click 3D and New 3D Extrusion from Selected Layer. If you see this message, click Yes. I did an in-depth tutorial on using the 3D feature, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link as well. Open back your Layers panel and click the background to make it active. Go back to 3D, New Mesh from Layer, and Postcard. Shift-click on the text layer to highlight it as well, and go back to 3D and merge 3D layers. Open back the 3D panel and click the light bulb icon. Open the Properties panel if it already isn't open. Uncheck IBL, which is the image-based lights. Immediately, your image will become black. At the bottom right of the 3D panel, click the light bulb icon and click New Spotlight. Click the coordinates icon and in the X position, type in 6.47, the X angle 0.1, the Y position 14.66, the Y angle 45.8, the Z position 7.42, and the Z angle minus 43.2. Next, we'll widen the cone and adjust the hotspot. Click the spotlight icon and check light fall off. This allows us to change the amount of illumination of the spotlight over distance. Check shadow. Slide the softness to 30% or just type it in. I'll make the cone 61.4 degrees and the hotspot 37 degrees. Make your 3D image bigger in your document by clicking Environment and with your slide tool active, go outside your document and drag down. To rotate your entire image, open the Rotate tool, go outside your document, and drag up and to the right. To reposition your entire document, open the Drag tool and drag it. We're ready to render it, but before we do, let's check your 3D preferences. Go to Edit, Preferences, and 3D. The ray tracer threshold determines the quality of the rendering. The higher the threshold is, the longer it'll take to render, but the less noise you'll have in your final image. Its default amount is 5, but you may want to decrease it to 3 or 4 if it's taking too long to render. VRAM is the video card's memory. The amount I've allotted Photoshop to use is not necessarily what you should use because your computer may have its own requirements. To render your image, click the Render icon. It could take anywhere between a few minutes to over an hour to render it, depending on your computer's specs and the threshold amount. After it's rendered, to brighten dark areas of your image, first make a composite snapshot. To do this, open your Layers panel and click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Press Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. The shadow's default amount is 35%, which for this image is way too bright. Slide it all the way to the left, and then slowly drag the slider to the right until there's just enough detail in the shadows. Or you can type in the amount. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. To crop your image, open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag it over the area you want to keep. Go to Image and Crop. Then, deselect it. To fit it onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching!